trying to float in the air. You see, I ask this, brothers, because when people come to us for confession and confessional, that's the experience they should have, is they're leaving. They should have the experience of walking out of the confessional and feel like they're floating on air. I think this is one of the more important tasks that the Lord has blessed the Capuchin Order with, hearing confessions. He's called us to be missionaries of mercy in the confessional. See, it's our job to help reconcile people with their Lord again. And recently, this was affirmed by Pope Francis in St. Peter's when he met with one of the largest gatherings ever of Capuchins. And he said that the Capuchins have a tradition of being men of forgiveness, always being willing to forgive. He also said that we have a tradition in our order of having great confessors. So brothers, how are we supposed to live up to this tradition? I think the answer is actually pretty simple. In order for us to be missionaries of mercy and to give the people an experience of God's mercy and his forgiveness, we ourselves need to seek that out as well. We need to take advantage of frequent confession ourselves. Because how can we give the mercy of God to people if we haven't experienced it ourselves? So what are some other reasons we need to go to confession? You see, when we're baptized into Christ, we're given an amazing gift. We're given the gift of eternal life. However, because of our sinful nature, it's easy for us to lose that gift. For many different reasons, often we can become confused and become obsessed with worldly desires and worldly distractions. And as we allow them to come into us and distract us, at the same time, they're pushing the Holy Spirit out. When this happens, brothers, it's easy for us to begin to lose our love for Christ and for his church. So how do we let this happen? See, again, when we receive baptism, when we're baptized into Christ, not only are we giving eternal life, but we're also given the gift of an invitation to become good friends, personal relationship with Christ. But like any relationship, it takes work to keep it strong. And we do this by spending time with Christ, through prayer, through reading the scriptures, through receiving the sacraments, through Mass, through spiritual direction. And the more we do this, the stronger that relationship grows. And the closer we become to Christ, the stronger we are when it comes time to resist the temptations of Satan. However, on the flip side, when we start to neglect these things, that relationship begins to fail. And we become more open to being snared by the devil and his temptations. So it's important for us, brothers, to take part in frequent confession so we can keep that strength of our relationship with God open. I'd also like to pause for just a moment and reflect on the role of the religious brother as missionaries of mercy. Because mercy and forgiveness are not just something that a priest can give. We're all called to do it. Again, recently when Pope Francis was addressing the Capuchins, when he said the Capuchins have a tradition of being men of forgiveness, notice he didn't say something. He left out a particular word. I think it was intentional. He didn't say Capuchin priests. He said Capuchins. You see, many times I've witnessed, and I've also experienced a couple of times myself, brothers being out in public, and they have their habit. Somebody will walk up to them, and they'll just start unloading their life to them. They'll unload their burdens. They'll talk about their sins. And more often than not, they don't care if you're a priest or not. They just want somebody to listen to them. So I think religious brothers can be just as effective as religious priests when they're good listeners of mercy and forgiveness. I mean, when you think about it, we have an amazing example of an American Capuchin who did this, Solanus Casey. When he was ordained a simplex priest, which means he couldn't hear confessions and he couldn't preach. But that didn't stop him from being a missionary of mercy. It soon got out that he was an amazing listener. And as soon as that got out, people from all over started to flock to him, to talk to him. And more often than not, they would go to see him first and unload their burdens to him before they would go see a priest in the confessional. So I think it's important, brothers,